In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Next Tuesday, the day after tomorrow, we are going to celebrate the Feast of the Cross. In our church, we celebrate two separate Feasts of the Cross in our liturgical year. The first one, as of next Tuesday, 2/17 or September 27, the first Feast of the Cross to commemorate the discovery of the Holy Cross by Empress Helena, the mother of Constantine. The second one, in March 19, Baramoda 10, according to the Coptic calendar, to commemorate the manifestation of the Holy Cross in the 7th century during the reign of Roman Emperor Heraclius. And of course, the big, big celebration of the cross on Good Friday, where during the Holy Week prepare ourselves to emphasize about the crucifixion of our Lord Jesus Christ. And this is the big, big celebration of the cross. The cross is very important in our life. You cannot enjoy the joyful of resurrection without sharing the crucifixion, without carry the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. As he himself said, if you'd like to be my disciples, deny yourself, carry the cross, and follow me. If you go back to the early church, and even before the early church, the time of Christ, Jesus Christ, our Lord, talked many times about cross and crucifixion and carry the cross to prepare his disciples and us to accept the idea of the crucifixion, redemption, salvation. It showed the greatness of God's love to us. As it mentioned what the Lord said in the Gospel of St. John, chapter 3, verse 16, God so loved the world, so that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believed in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And also the disciples, after they received the power of the Holy Spirit, start to talk about the cross, carry the cross, and live the life of sacrifice for the sake of the Lord. And after that, you can see if we go through the history of the church, from generation to generations, one century to the other, how will our church honor and respect and venerate the cross? Of course, the cross and the Lord Jesus Christ who was crucified on the cross, and this is the most important. The Holy Cross held a prominent and reverent place in the early church life and worship, and we still do the same. The Christian used to make the sign of the cross on their foreheads 3 times daily as a sign of protection. And many times up till today, when someone go through some difficulties, يقولوا باسم الصليب, make the sign of the cross, because it is the sign of protection. Because our Lord Jesus Christ, who was crucified on the cross, can protect us against any dangers, against anything. I would like to read for you what the scholar Tertullian wrote in the year 211. This is the beginning of the 3rd century, and I will quote, at every forward step, and movement. At every going in and out, when we put on our clothes and our shoes, when we pass, when we sit at the table, when we light the lamp, in all the ordinary action of daily life, we trace upon the forehead the sign of the cross. To that extent, it is the sign of protection. Also, I would like to read to you what is written in the apostolic tradition, which revealed to us the importance of the sign of the cross in the early Christian spirituality and devotion. If you are tempted, seal your forehead with the sign of the cross, for this is the sign of passion and made manifested against the devil. So it is the sign of protection and the sign against the devil. Imagine how much the devil terrified from the cross. And this is why around us millions of people, they don't like the cross. They don't want us to put the cross above the tower or above the dome. They said it is aggravate them. It is aggravate them when they see the sign of the cross. So we should not put it because you should not aggravate them. Although we are in the 21st century and we are entitled to do whatever we want as much as we don't hurt the other. The true meaning of freedom, that you are free to do whatever you want, you are free to worship whatever you want, as long as your freedom does not exceed the freedom of the other. But they don't understand. They hate the cross. Because the devil himself is frightened from the cross. But for us, the cross is a sign of protection and the sign and manifest the power against the devil, the Satan, and all his followers. The cross was not only a sign of protection and a sign of power against the devil, but also a sign for worship and veneration as well. As we began our prayers with the sign of the cross, in our public servants, as we, for service, as we see today, and every divine liturgy, every liturgical prayers, and also in our individual prayers, when we pray at home, and when we read the book of the hours, we always make the sign of the cross. You witness that when Abuna move around with the innocent, everyone make the sign of the cross. Just I would like to notice one thing. Yeah, we have also to make the sign of the cross before we receive communion and after we receive communion. But please, nothing mentioned in the early church time, neither up to today, you have to make it when you are very close to Abuna. تعرفش الناس بتحللها أول حكاية دي؟ يرشم الصليب when Abuna carry the chalice like that. Most of the time can hurt the chalice and something can happen. You can make the sign of the cross 3, 4, 5, 6 feet before you approach Amuna, and 3, 4, 5, 6 feet after. You still make it, you take a blessing, but we have to be very careful. We have to be very careful. And no matter how many times I make this announcement, we still some people do. So please try to remember, because you have to be responsible. And I have to be also responsible of what I carry in my hand, the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who was crucified for our salvation. So we make the sign of the cross. In every sacrament in the church and every liturgical prayer in the church, we started with the cross and we concluded with the cross. Abuna and the deacons, before they wear the tunia, Abuna make the sign of the cross 3 times in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. When we bless the element, the bread and the wine and the water, we bless it in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit with the sign of the cross. When we have engagement or wedding, we also bring and bless the rings with the sign of the cross in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Look to our church here. Of course, we have cross on the dome and cross in the tower. No one dare to touch us. We can do whatever we want. It's a free country. And we have to insist to do that in our home country in Egypt. But also we make 76 cross, stone cross around the building, around this particular church. And in our tunia, in our vestment, we have the sign of the cross. Look to the decoration here. Sorry, it is not a decoration. It meant something that we proud of the cross. We carry the cross. We follow the crucified, and we proud of it. Not only the cross is the sign of protection and the sign of power against the devil and the sign of worship and veneration, but also the cross, it reminds us about the redemption of our Lord Jesus Christ. And this is the most important. As I said in the beginning, it revealed to us the love of God the Father who offered God the Son, and God the Son who offered himself. Great love. God so loved the world so that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. As the Lord said, there is no greater love than this, if someone offer his life for the sake of the others. And this is what the Lord did for us. In the paradise of the desert father, explain how much the sign of the cross meant to them. They used to pray, some of them, when they extended their arms like that, and they pray, which when we make like that, it makes the sign of the cross. And sometimes they used to pray like that for many, many hours. For example, Saint Arsenius started his prayer when he stretches his hand all night until the sun rises. And of course, you know, Saint Bishoy, he used to pray for many, many times. One time he continued as in 3 weeks to pray for the Lord. In the Divine Liturgy, Saint Augustine instructed his people and said, let them all sign themselves with the sign of the cross of Christ. Let them all respond, Amen. Let them all sing Alleluia. Let all sing Amen. Let all sing Alleluia. The day after tomorrow, we are going to celebrate the Feast of the Cross. We are going to have the Divine Liturgy from 8 o'clock to 11. We'll add 1 hour to the regular time because we have the procession of the cross, where we have 12 stations. We stop and pray and read. And so beautiful. If you have time, it will be great to come and attend. In one of the prayer at the beginning, we say, and we also the people, the son of the Orthodox, we bow down to the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hail to you, O cross, the sign of salvation. Hail to you, O cross, the sign of salvation. So beautiful. And we summarize also the story when Helena, the mother of Constantine, the emperor, discovered and what happened. And you know the story. They found 3 crosses under a huge mountain of garbage. And what the people try to do nowadays, it's the same what the Jewish and the Gentile did at the time of Christ. What happened is, was when Jesus Christ was crucified and after the resurrection, some miracles happened from the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. So the Jew and the Romans come together and said, well, put the cross in this area and throw your garbage on it for over 300 years, from the time of Jesus Christ until the time of Helen. And Helen, the mother of Constantine, after he became Christian, she longing to find out the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. And her son at the emperor gave her 3,000 soldiers. She went to Jerusalem and she asked, where is the cross of Jesus? Some people don't know, some people know, and the people who know, they don't want to tell. Until she sees on one of them, and he spoke and said, under the mountain of garbage. Imagine garbage for 300 years, because he cannot stand the power of the cross. And as I said, some of people still do that in different way, up till today. This is why St. Paul said, the sign for the message of the cross is foolishness for those who are perishing, but it is for us who are being saved is the power of God. كلمة الصليب عند الهالكين جهالة أما عندنا نحن المخلصين فهي قوة الله. So after that, he told her under the mountain of garbage, 3,000 soldiers move, and then they found 3 crosses. It's more difficult. What can we do? It happened that God allowed one person passed away, and they went to the cemetery to bury him. And then the bishop of Jerusalem told her, stop the casket, put the casket on one of the cross, and whatever, if the dead man will arise, then it will be the true cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. They put it in the first one, second one, nothing happened, and then they put it on the third cross, and that guy raised from the dead. Many miracles used to happen. So she was very happy. She took the sign of the cross. She sent part to her son in Constantinople, and she built a beautiful churches, many churches. The Church of the Resurrection, the Church of the Crucifixion, many, many churches, and they still exist up till today. What I would like to say that we have to live the life of Christianity in its right meaning. As I said in the beginning, you cannot rejoice in the resurrection of the Lord without sharing the suffering of the cross. And this is why our Lord Jesus Christ said, unless we suffer with him, sorry, St. Paul said, unless we suffer with him, we cannot glorify it with him. إِلَّمْ نَتَأَلَّمْ مَعْهُ لَن نَتَمَجَّدْ أَيْضًا مَعْهُ. But it is very important when we make the sign of the cross, we really meant it. When we make the sign of the cross, we remember the love of our Lord Jesus Christ. And as I said, God so loved the world. When we make the sign of the cross, we believe, we reveal our belief. Imagine with an action is less than 2-3 seconds, as we say in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. We reveal our belief in the oneness of God and in the Trinity of God. We reveal the love of God the Father, who sent his only begotten Son on earth and the womb of Saint Mary, we say in the name of the Father and the Son, who came and saved us. We reveal our belief that the power of the Holy Spirit, which moved us from left to right, and we became on the right hand of God the Father. When we make the sign of the cross, we reveal our belief about our redemption and about our salvation, and that we have been saved, and there is no salvation outside the cross. As the Bible said, there is no salvation without the shed of the blood. When we make the sign of the cross, we reveal the summary of all our belief in Christianity. And as I said, the sign of the cross is the powerful of God. The sign will give us the power of God. You cannot survive, we cannot survive in this world without the word of God. For us being saved is the power of God. This is why we have to be proud of the cross. But God forbid that I should boast except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, who was crucified for me and I for him. And this is Christianity. This is orthodoxy. Some people imagine they call themselves a Christian and they never make the sign of the cross. They never make the sign of the cross. And some people, very rare in their denomination, talk about the cross. They took the good result of the crucifixion, which is the resurrection. We have to live with the Lord, alleluia. And then after that, they don't practice. We are not going to insult other people, but for us, we take it one package. Unless we suffer with him, we cannot glorify with him. We have to live and carry and make the sign of the cross with true meaning to be able to share in the suffering of the Lord, and then we practice his glory here on earth and there in heaven. Glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.